All right, hello, let me turn my heater off. Hello, it's dark in here because I've been keeping my light off because my room is infested with ladybugs. I'll show you guys, but actually you may not really be able to see. Oh, ladybugs. And I don't know how they're getting here. It's like the more I kill them, the more come. So I'm not sure if they're trying to get in here because of, I don't know, like I know they're on the window probably because the sunlight, so I be keeping my light off so that they don't come on a light, because then it makes a sound every time and it really bothers me. And even last night, one was on my ceiling and it kept hitting it and I couldn't even sleep well because I was kept hearing that. But it's Monday. It's finals week, so good luck to those of you taking finals. But today really hasn't been the best day. I was worried about my dad, of course, and so I just kind of dropped it and I just called the hospital, and they took me through all of these steps basically to say that since my name isn't on the list for the person to know anything, any updates or anything about his status, that I can't know anything even though I'm his daughter, and that they tell his brother or his mom. And so they told me to reach out to one of them for updates, but at that point my anxiety was at an all-time high that I just started crying and just moved on to something else. So I met with my advisor earlier today and that went well. I was able to fix my schedule. I mentioned I had way too many classes on my schedule for next semester. That's gonna be my last semester in college. And I was gonna be taking almost 20 something credit hours, and that would not have even been feasible. So I had too many classes on there. I kind of doubled up on my credits on accident because I was looking at DegreeWorks, and DegreeWorks made it seem like I had to have a certain class that she told me that a class I already have is gonna count for that anyway. So I was able to remove a class, which was good, and fit in another class that I need for my minor. So I'm really happy about that. I'll be graduating right on time in May. I'm so excited and I'm so proud of myself. But after that, you guys, I really have just been, I've been forcing myself to do work. It's been really, really difficult for me. I don't know if it's depression or anxiety, but I've just really don't want to do anything. It's a weird feeling where I'm not tired, I'm not hungry, I don't feel anything, and I just don't want to sleep. I just want to sit. But then if I just sit, then I start thinking about things, so I just want to sleep. But then as I was trying to sleep earlier, I was thinking about my dad, and I was like hearing him talk to me and stuff, and I'm like, oh my god, I'm really, really tripping. But anyway, after I was hearing his voice, and then I couldn't even sleep because I was like, that's gonna make me sad. So, but earlier today, I managed to get enough energy to work on my lab report. I only worked on my lab report for 30 minutes, but I made so much progress. So I have to work on that a little more tonight because I really want to get that turned in tomorrow. But right now I really should work on something, but I just want to sleep, and it's a really bad feeling. It's really bad because I have so much to do, and I'm honestly such a dreamer and go-getter, and I like to produce things, but I can't produce right now because my mind. And you guys, I've been on YouTube watching Vlogmas videos like it's nothing. You would have thought somebody was paying me to sit and watch all these YouTubers, and of course, I love doing it. I really look up to some of those people, but it's making me feel very lonely and very sad. And it's literally December 7th, and I just feel like I'm alone. I don't feel anything related to the holiday season. I don't feel in the spirit, and this is usually my favorite time of the year. So anyway, you guys, I was just thinking, there was a Christmas one year when my dad was in the hospital. I don't remember what he was there for, but I was a lot younger, and I just remember me, my mom, and my brother actually went to the hospital on Christmas, and we opened gifts there, and just the thought of him possibly not even being home this year, but us not being able to go, it's just my thoughts though, so it's fine. Anyway, I was gonna say something. Oh, yesterday, I don't know what came over me, but I ended up buying clothes online from Forever 21. I've been wanting to buy clothes for a very long time, and Forever 21 was having, first of all, I shop in their sales section, and then they were having an extra sale. So I got four clothing items for $50, which was really good. And I didn't even, I wasn't even supposed to spend the money on that, but I did. So that's what I'm gonna be looking forward to getting at some point when I get home, and I'll be doing a try-on haul for those. Other than that, you guys, it is 4:45. My camera's about to die, and I haven't talked to anybody today. I mean, I texted my mom, but it's not the same as calling. But I told her about the ladybugs, and she told me to call maintenance, but I'm not going through maintenance. I only have maybe 6 more days left in this dorm room. I can do it. I'm tired. I'm tired. I'm tired. But I don't know, y'all. I need to stop looking at social media so much because it's making it worse. I really thought that social media was helping me get better, and like instead of me thinking about bad things, I would just get on social media. But social media is not good for me. It's not good for my personal development, and it's not good for the person I'm trying to become. If I'm trying to become someone who knows how to detach themselves from social media, and who is not just so indulged in that, I need to start being that person. But it's so hard because I keep feeling like if I don't have my phone in my hand, if I'm not scrolling, then I'm crying, or I'm just terrible. I feel terrible. But that's all in my head. I think I'm gonna try to go for a walk. I can't even go for a walk or anything because I could, but I have the on-call phones, so I might just walk a little bit right outside my room. But my camera's about to die, so I'm probably gonna just talk till it dies. But I'm vlogging every day, so. And I hate that I'm having to start this channel off with me being in this mindset, so depressed, and don't even wanna. I can't even show y'all anything. I'm not doing anything. But I need to make an appointment with the therapist people at my school. I don't even feel depressed anymore, though. I don't feel like I need. Who's calling me?
Social Security Administration Legal Department. The reason of this message is to inform you that SSA Department is filing lawsuit against you. An arrest warrant has been released on your name due to legal enforcement actions filed on your Social Security number for fraudulent activities. To get more information about this case, file from federal database, press 1 and speak to our agent now.
Wow. That was fake. That's not real. But I mailed my mom her birthday card. I mailed it today. So I don't know. I want to go for a walk or something. But the vlogs will get better. When my dad comes home, I can't wait to just record my dad. Oh, my hands are itchy. I don't know if y'all hear that, but every time the ladybug moves, it makes a sound that I hate. I hate that. I don't like sounds when I'm trying to, just chill. It's almost been 10 minutes. I'm gonna talk to my, I don't know what I wanna do. Oh, my friend called me yesterday at 11 o'clock p.m. I was in a bed. So So that was weird. I think my dad has been in the hospital for, a month? A little over a month, almost going on 2 months. I guess I'm gonna just sit here. It's like I feel like crying, but the tears aren't even there. Oh my God, I just remember my clothes are in the dryer downstairs. I gotta go get those clothes. No. Man. I don't feel like doing that. The last thing I'll say that's been on my mind is like my dad coming home. Since the only two people on his list are my uncle and mom, that means that they'll probably be the ones that they'll contact about him coming home. And I won't be home for a week, so I really don't want him to come home for a week. But oh no. I'm trying to think. If my uncle goes picks him up, probably my uncle might go pick him up. And taking to get a haircut. And then I don't know where they might go after that. I mean, I'm thinking home, but y'all, our home situation is not. I can't even talk about it on camera, but I don't know. I haven't talked to some people in some days. I'm really alone, bro. Wonder what my brother's doing. I might just go to sleep.